all plans that are offered on a go-forward basis have to cover these 10 essential health benefits. I find that there's confusion in the marketplace with essential health benefits and preventive health services. So two different topics, and again, back to the spirit of the basics, the 10 essential benefits have to be covered, meaning they're eligible service to be covered under the plan that you buy. They may be subject to deductible, they may be subject to some coinsurance or co-payments, but they're in the plan. Preventive health services also are mandated to be covered, but they're covered at 100%. So the good news is that the law says preventive health services, you have first dollar coverage. So if you need preventive services, the other good news of the law, it says that these 10 essential health benefits have to be found within your plan. So maybe that's easy for everyone in this room to understand, but it's a subtle difference that I wanted to talk about. So when you think about the spirit of the shopping, in some regards, the shopping should be easier, right? To Bruce's point, there is more, the plans that are available have some consistency in terms of benefits that are covered. So there is some consistency. It is not to say that they are the same. So the law said these are the things that need to be covered. The law didn't define exactly how they needed to be covered. But you will find a lot more commonality across carriers, health insurance carriers, than you've found in the past. So I think that's good. So the shopping experience in terms of comparing the coverage levels from an apples-to-apples basis should be easier for business owners and individuals, frankly. The question that I think, and you know, Bruce started to talk about some of the stories that are out in the news, where the shopping gets confusing is today, one of the things that the law does is the law makes subsidies available for individuals, and this will come up in all of the sessions, I'm sure, but I'll give you the easy, since I'm talking about it first, I can take the easy part of the subsidies. So the subsidies apply for those that are in Illinois. If you fall between you or, you know, you think about your employees, if they fall between 138% and 400% of the federal poverty level, if that's their household income, then they're eligible for a subsidy that can be used to purchase an on-exchange health insurance plan.
Let's just give some numbers around that.
Sure.
So that goes up to about, I want to say like, is it $47,000 for a family of four? Or does it go much higher than that? What is the number?
Do you want to jump in? For a family of four, it's about $94,000,
okay,
for that, because it's four times the actual average on it. So.
Okay.
So it's a pretty substantial. If you look at a lot of, I mean, the average income for a lot of our employees and just citizens, I mean, it's much lower than that. So we see a very large swath of people that will be eligible for tax credits.
Okay. So median income in the country right now is about $52,000. Mm-hmm. This goes up to $94,000. Go ahead, Kevin.
So the subsidy, as you could imagine, it the lower you are, you know, if you're closer to 138% of the federal poverty level, you have a higher subsidy, and then it slopes down. So the shopping experience has changed, right? These subsidies did not exist in the past, so that wasn't part of the shopping experience. Today, what you're seeing a lot of in the media about the HealthCare.gov not working to the level that either consumers needed to or the government expected, that's the part that people are having a hard time getting their hands around on, right? Because that information sits within healthcare.gov. So at the moment, the shopping experience is, I think, complicated and a little difficult. But once that gets up and working, people will be able to look at the premium cost for the health insurance plan that they may be considering. They'll be able to see what their subsidy, if they fall between that 138 and 400% of the federal poverty level, is, what their subsidy level is, and then they'll see their sort of net cost in terms of a health insurance plan. So in time, I think the shopping experience will be easier.